Hey, what's up everyone? Have you ever wanted to make your own game, but thought it would be too difficult? Well,
let me tell you, it's not like that at all. No, sir.
I'll show you just how easy it is to make a 2D game in Unity. You're welcome here. I'll show you step by step how to make a simple space shooter game. I'll be sharing some useful tips and tricks along the way. And I'll provide you with the scripts and sprites so you can make your own version of the game. You won't believe how easy it is to create a fully functional game from scratch. You'll be amazed at how quickly you can get started, and I guarantee that you'll be hooked once you see how fun it is to create your own game. So stick around until the end of the video, because you don't want to miss out on this exciting opportunity. If you're enjoying this video so far, be sure to hit that subscribe button and notification bell to stay up to date with all of my latest videos. Also, please leave a comment below letting me know what you think of this video and if you have any suggestions for the future content. I'll be sharing the script that I use in this game. We'll take a look at how they work, and I'll explain how you can customize them to suit your own game. These scripts are easy to understand, and even if you are new to coding, you should be able to follow along. The provided code includes several scripts used in a simple 2D game developed in Unity. Each script has a specific purpose and is attached to a game object in a scene. So let's get started with the main idea of this video, which is to show you how to create a 2D space shooter game in which the player controls a ship that can move and shoot projectiles. The player must avoid enemies while trying to destroy as many as possible to increase their score. I have a footage of my screen where I demonstrate how to create this game from scratch. You'll learn how to set up the controls for the spaceship, create projectiles at enemy ships, create explosion, and even add to a scoring system. First, we add a player sprite from assets you can download from the link in the description. We scale, place this sprite, rigid body and box collider 2D, and we'll add a player script which is responsible for the controlling player's movement and creating projectiles. The player moves using the ASDW keys and shoots projectile using the spacebar or P key. You can change on the other key if you like. It has a public variables for the projectile prefab and player speed, as well as private variables for collision detection and moving boundaries. The script's functions include start, which is called once when the script is first loaded, update, which is called every frame and calls the player movement and spawn projectile on key function, and on collision 2D, which is called when the player collides with other object. If the colliding object has the tag enemy, the script loads sample scene level, which is game over condition. We specify projectile prefab in the inspector for the player. For the projectile, we add a rigid body and collider 2D and target projectile. And projectile script controls the behavior of the projectile. It has a public variable for projectile speed and functions for moving the projectile to the right and destroying it when it goes off screen. Note, we offset a projectile spawning point of the player's collider to prevent uncontrolled player rotation we don't want. Next, we make an enemy prefab. We do placing and scaling, rigid body, and adding the collider. Tag as enemy and add a script. The enemy script is responsible for controlling the behavior of the enemy objects in the game. It has a public variable for enemy speed and functions for moving the enemy to the left and destroying it when it all goes off screen. To continuously spawn enemy ships at the random Y position within a set range, we attach enemy spawning script to our game controller empty. It contains a start method that calls the enemy spawn coroutine, which repeatedly calls the spawn enemy method with the delay set by enemy spawn time variable. The spawn enemy method instantiates an enemy to spawn prefab at a random Y position and a fixed X position defined by the enemy starting X variable. When a collision occurs, it destroys the enemy ships and the projectile and spawns an explosion. Additionally, it calls a call score script method, which finds the score script attached to the UI object in the scene and calls add to score void method. For explosions, we have two prefabs to have a big orange explosion and a small but fast white explosion. For UI, we use the canvas and text with the tags GUI and the score script, which displays the current score on the screen. It contains a score variable that is incremented by the add to score void method, which is called by the destroy enemy script. The print score method updates the text component attached to the script with the current score. So here you have it, folks. That's how you create a 2D game in Unity. I hope you found this video informative and helpful. Remember, you can always download the script and sprite I use in this game, so you can create your own version of this game. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more exciting content.